Alrighty, time for round four. Looks like we've found an opponent. Let's go ahead and play first. Yeah. Whew, yeah, let's keep this hand. This is a great hand because it's got Ancestral Recall and Library of Alexandria. Also because I get to go turn one library. If my opponent doesn't wasteland it or force me to use Force of Will, then I can use library turn two. And if they do, backup plan of Island Ancestral Recall, not bad at all. Just don't play Bazaar of Baghdad. That's really all I ask. I'd also prefer my opponent doesn't play Wasteland, I suppose. What do I want my opponent to play? Probably just a blue land and say go. No. Flooded Strand for Tundra, cast like Preordain is fine with me. Mox, okay. Still on board with this. Standstill? No, Jace. Okay. I'm gonna let Jace resolve here because getting value off of library is worth a lot. And I mean, Jace is good, but it's not the end of the world if my opponent gets to use Jace a little bit. Those gushes aren't great draws, but I still think I'm doing fine here. So there is a danger in getting in trying to resolve Ancestral and getting into a fight over that, because I'm gonna let this Jace loot resolve. Because if I Ancestral and my opponent counters it and then I force, I will not be able to library and I could be in a very bad position. On the other hand, if my opponent plays a Monastery Mentor here. So, what order do I do things in? I'm gonna have to fight over this. The question is, do I force seven cards? I guess I force first. Pitching a gush. If my opponent forces back, I Ancestral. Basically, I would like my opponent to force pitching a Mental Misstep, if possible. So I'm gonna lead with Force of Will. All right, so I forced. Pitch Preordain. All right, I'm gonna Ancestral in response. Hopefully, one of their last two cards isn't Mental Misstep. If it is, I'm gonna force the Mental Misstep, pitching the Gush, and hope to draw another blue card for Force of Will. If their last card's another Mental Misstep, then I just get wrecked here. But I don't know that I can do much about that. Oh, their last card is Gush? That has to be what they're thinking about. If you have Mental Misstep, you snap it off. Well, if they gush and miss, then that's not too bad for me. Okay, so what's the plan here? I guess it's draw a blue card. Squall Therapy is not looking hot. If this was a blue card, I'd be much, much safer here. This is quite the stack. Let's see what my opponent's next play is. I still really think that they've got gush. I mean, yeah, again, it's online. They could just be walking away and doing something else. But if they're thinking, I think gush is the most likely scenario. All right, I drew a blue card. Ooh, so that's gonna happen. If I'd drawn a swords, I would have swords, but I'm gonna force pitching Baleful Strix here because I think gush is gonna be good. All right, now my opponent could gush, but now it's much worse because if they gush, they have to hit force blue card, and that's just not gonna do it. Whereas before they could gush and hit misstep and completely wreck me. Okay. I mean, and maybe they don't have all those things. Maybe I'm reading into it too much. But thinking, I mean, whether or not they do have the gush, thinking through what your opponent could have and what they're thinking about is really relevant. This is the sort of thing you should be thinking about during a game of Magic. If my opponent, their last card's Mental Misstep, obviously they snap it off. There's no other free cards, you can narrow down pretty quickly. I mean, unless they're playing a card like Daze, which they're just not going to be. So the question now is, do I gush immediately? I think so. I think I'm gonna add blue black and I'm gonna cast gush. See if I draw something interesting here. It's a little awkward here that I've drawn my only double blue card. I'm just not gonna cast Cabal Therapy here because next turn I get to use library. All right. My opponent currently has nothing they can flash back off of Jace. So they get to loot. If they draw a Monastery Mentor, things could be annoying. Well, let's see. Maybe I should not have cast Gush that turn. It's possible, certainly. Discard Ruby, flip Jace. They can plus Jace. That's the most useful thing, you know. And they don't have Gush in hand, so all that speculation was for naught. It's alright, though. Library. I like Mental Misstep. Let's go Underground C, and let's cast Ponder. What am I looking for here? Don't hate Force of Will. Yes, yes, good, good. Do this, pass the turn. Basically, I'm worried about a Monastery Mentor, though I have a Source to Plowshares, so maybe that's not a huge worry. And then next turn, I can use Gitaxian Probe plus Cabal Therapy if I would like to. Alright, Jace is getting minused. I didn't imagine that this game would come down to Library getting reactive. It feels like the late game already, but I guess it's just turn four. This has been an action-packed game. That stack with Mentor, Force, Force, Ancestral, Misstep, Force was pretty good. And it's done. I'm drawing Probe. Let's go Gitaxian Probe. And I'm going to play this before playing my land because I want to build a library in response if something happens, like if my opponent counters Probe with like a Mental Misstep. Mana Drain, Supreme Verdict, Swords to Plowshares. Jason 9 is an actual threat, by the way, so I guess I should probably worry about that a little. Mana Drain, Verdict, Swords. Okay, so my opponent's got some defense. Playing my land and saying go. Yeah. And my plan here is to end of turn library. So Jace ticking up to 8. And then cast Dig Through Time. My opponent... Okay, I still know every card in their hand. Interesting, they play the Mox. Because they don't want to get therapied away or something. Cast Dig, exiling everything but Ancestral. My opponent's going to drain this. I'm going to force the mana drain. And then I'm going to try to go Mentor, dig into Mentor, and then go Mentor, Therapy or Verdict, Flashback or Therapy. Well, I guess they have Pearl, so now they have Swords up. So I'd like to find Mentor and Misstep here. All right, well, I'll take Mentor. I guess I could take Snapcaster also. Yeah, that's probably pretty good. Well, Mentor, Snapcaster. Okay. So now, what to do? If I draw a Misstep, it's pretty easy. And a Cabal Therapy. All right, so, Jace is on 8. I guess I can win fast enough. My opponent's not going to play 7 spells in a row. All right, so I'm just going to do it this way. I'm at 8 cards, so I go to 7 cards after this. Name. Swords. Oh. Swords to Plowshares. They have Supreme Verdict in hand. Draw off Library. And then... Ooh, Baleful Strix. Actually, that was a convenient little draw. Oh, wait. No, I can't do that. I have to get Tundra. All right. Just get Tundra, go. It's too risky for me to do otherwise. Because I need to hit this. I mean, my opponent's Jace Ultimate. Like, 5 cards every time they play a spell is not nothing. So it's the emblem. But it's not going to kill me in 3 turns. It's going to kill me in, like, 4 or 5 turns, especially if I have counter magic. Oh, they have a mentor. Okay, well, that's actually fine. Because they can't even Jace and replay a spell here. Okay, so now... I guess I just swords end of turn. It's fine. I mean, either way works. Yeah, drawing a card is good here. Oh, I drew a black land anyway, so it's the land. Monastery Mentor. And Cabal Therapy or Supreme Verdict. Oh. I hate that my graveyard pops out, but I refuse to move my graveyard, so maybe that's my fault. they get to Jace now, but I have the second Monastery Mentor, and that also minuses their Jace. So... Oh, no, I don't want to name Monastery Mentor, I want to name Supreme Verdict. Green verdict countered, and I passed the turn. I guess I have to move this over. All right. Opponent's flashing back Supreme Verdict here, killing my mentor, but I have a second mentor, and they only have one card in hand. So I think, unless I draw something that changes things, I'm going to snap Caster Ancestral here. So what I could do, what is an option, is I could flashback therapy with Snapcaster naming. Actually, instead of librarying, actually this is, oh wait, this is gonna be much better. All right, let's, so I was gonna Ancestral, but why don't I play Monastery Mentor? I know my opponent can't counter it. And then I'm gonna Cabal Therapy my opponent, sacking the Snapcaster. And I'm going to name Mental Misstep. This is just safe. And because I'm getting extra tokens here, I can just take whatever my opponent's last card is as well. All right, Mental Misstep. That's Force of Will. So I could take the Force of Will here. Let's Ancestral Recall myself first. And remember, my opponent can minus Jace in order to cast Source to Pleasure. So if I find a Mental Misstep here, then I'm in really good shape. Let's just cast Probes, and now I just want to stack up the Monks, because even if my opponent kills my Mentor, I'll still be in good shape. And I think it's probably worth therapying the Force of Will here. Yeah, I've got a lot of Cabal therapies, and this way I still get a Monk back for it. Alright, so now I'm gonna name Force of Will. And my opponent can go ahead and Jace flashback Swords to Plowshares, but I'll still have three Monks in play. That'll end things pretty quickly. Okay, they're gonna probe, and my hand isn't insane, but I've seen a lot more cards. I have 27 cards in my deck. My opponent has 41, so I've seen 14 more. So, assuming, like, so what's my opponent's best draw here? I guess if they drew a Monastery Mentor, and then they go Mentor, Jace, Flashback, Swords, Swords, your Mentor, but then I still just get to Swords their Mentor. I guess if they draw, like, a Treasure Cruise, they could kind of go off. Alright, they minused, I assume, on Swords. Yeah. Mentor down. And that is all. Now I'm back to Library mode again. I've never been on and off Library so many times. Oh, Probe makes things a little easier. I don't have much of a care for my life total here, as you can see. All right, what's my opponent got? They have the Mental Misstep. All right. I draw a Flusterstorm, which is a nice draw, actually. It's Cabal Therapy. They're just going to misstep it, even though it doesn't matter. Technically, it's better not to, because what if I name the wrong card? Can I actually kill my opponent here? I have to pump monks three more times. I actually can just win. Because I can play Baleful Strix, Swords it, and then I can also cast Preordain and Flusterstorm it if I want. Alright. Always yielding on the monks, you know, the last triggers that they have. Alright, and Swords Baleful Strix, because why not? I'm going to attack my opponent. Attack with all creatures. Humph. Alright. Playing Mentor Mirrors again. Sorry, you poor disenchant. It's okay. I like having a disenchant to tutor for anyway. Like, well, tutor by tutor, I guess I mean cast Dig and Treasure Cruise and Ancestral for. And just putting either a balance or a Path to Exile, and I haven't really figured out which one's best. I guess I honestly don't know. I'll go with Path, though. I don't know if this is a good sign. I lost all my other game ones, and I won this one, but I won all my other matches. On the other hand, this hand is fantastic in the mirror, because I have Turn on Library. I've had Turn on Library a lot this tournament, actually. And then I get to combo Therapy Probe, and I've got even a Force of Will to protect from some faster draws, and a Source of Pleasures to help protect from Mentor. The part of the reason Mentor's so good is that even if my opponent like lets me swords their mentor. If they went like mentor preordain and then I swords it, and they cast a misstep and I cast a misstep, they end up with two monks in play, which is kind of the real deal. All right, what you got here? Two tundras, mismatched tundras. Come on, please. You have hexproof? Oh, I see. That's gonna protect my opponent from Cabal Therapy, which I guess is fine. Draw, and I don't want to discard here, so I'm just gonna go ahead and swords the Aegis right now. The Aegis has decided to go farming. And if my opponent counters that, they counter that, whatever. Alright. I'm more concerned about a Monastery Mentor than an Aegis of the Gods. Like, yeah, it blanks my Cabal Therapy, but the fact that it's trading for Cabal Therapy while hitting for two is just not that big of an issue. If my opponent plays a Monastery Mentor, though, then I'm going to be willing to fight. That's what this looks like. Draw a card. This is actually tough. I guess I'll pitch Probe. It's between Probe and Gush, honestly. One of the advantages to keeping Probe is that I can go Monastery, Mentor, Probe, and I can just target myself. I can't target my opponent with Aegis in play. But I don't think I need to do any of that stuff. Just Library. Yeah, Mental Misstep's good. Alright. So even if my opponent has another Mentor here, I get to Snapcaster Swords. And then now I can go Mentor with Mental Misstep back up to stop a Swords. I just don't like tapping Mentor into that. Okay. Porn has two cards in hand, so they're not playing a ton of spells right now. It's possible that I want to... Ooh, my opponent not attacking from Fear of Snapcaster. I like that. Just get another Tundra here. I'm just thinning my deck. Land. I have 8 cards in hand. I guess I'll thin a little bit more. I'll get an Underground Sea now. I'll draw a card. I think I'll just play the Monastery Mentor because I've got backup, and then I'll probe myself, which sounds great. And my opponent doesn't get to look. I just get to look, and then I pass. Though the way my opponent tapped their mana, they did not leave up Swords, they left up Pyroblast. That's actually really good information. So either they have neither of them and they don't care, or they have Pyroblast. They just don't have Swords in their hand. So at best they can play two spells unless they have another Mentor. Oh, Gideon, Ally of Zendikar? What in the world? Okay. Sure. I mean, I'm not going to gush to try to counter that, because next turn my plan is to go Snapcaster Swords. Gideon. Whoa. All right. My opponent is going deep, I guess. Sure, and they can attack me with their Mentor. Yeah, I'm gonna take it. Okay, good again, huh? All right. That's interesting. Moxen, I was gonna say, Moxen will be good. All right, let's play a Mox Jet. Let's trigger these. Actually, I should yield. And yield, all right. Draw with the Library. Gross. All right. Because now my Mentor is going to be big enough that it can actually attack. Because I'm going to be able to cast lots of spells here. And here's where I can go Therapy myself. It does reveal, though, unlike Gitaxian Probe. So if I Therapy myself, then I end up showing my opponent my hand, but that's all right. All right. So I have a Lotus, so now I'm going to go Snappy. Well, am I going to cast Gush this turn? Let's map this out. I'm going to cast Swords, so Mentor's going to be a 5-5. I'm going to Swords the Mentor. Yeah, and then Monk will be a 4-4. I think I'm actually am going to Gush this turn, so let's add a blue and a white. Just cast Gush. My opponent, do they have the Pyroblast now? That would actually be good for me, because then I would get to cast this Mental Misstep. And that would be another spell. I mean, even if they don't Pyroblast the Gush, it's pretty hard to imagine they don't Pyroblast the Snapcaster. I am going off something fierce here. Alright. And Gush. Yeah. Alright, well, Force Level is fine. Let's go. Snapcaster. Let's go Swords to Plowshares. Let's go Swords to Plowshares, your Monastery Mentor. And I might just be able to attack my opponent. Attack him with a Mentor and a Monk. And I could, I haven't played a land yet, I could cast Cabal Therapy and flash it back. At this point, I don't think I need to, though. I'll wait till next turn to do that. I'll play a Tundra. And attack my opponent. Actually, they're just dead next turn. Let's just attack Gideon with both. Yeah, because one thing that actually could get me pretty well here is Supreme Verdict. Opponent's going to leave the Aegis in play. So I do have to worry about that. Losing to Supreme Verdict. I mean, I don't lose to Supreme Verdict. It's just, it's annoying. Because they kill everything and end up with Gideon in play. But I'm going to discard the Tarn. And I name Supreme Verdict because it's uncounterable, whereas everything else is counterable. Yeah, that's going to get misstepped for sure. I don't want them to, or counter, because I don't want them finding that Supreme Verdict. Make another Monk. Yeah, even if they have Supreme Verdict, I get to library and gush a bunch, like I should be okay, but it would be annoying, certainly. So my opponent's still holding on to a Pyroblast here, and still just trying to figure out when exactly to use it. Who knows? Gideon, Ally of Zendikar. So what does this do? It doesn't get Flusterstormed or Pyroblasted, which is nice. It's largely immune to Swords to Plowshares, since you don't have to attack with it. It works with Supreme Verdict. Yeah, interesting with balance. I don't know, costs 4 mana though. 4 mana spells are just... yeah, that costs a lot of mana. Alright, do you have it? My opponent apparently does not, so I'll take the match, go to 4-0. Well, it's a pretty sweet match here, or rather tournament. Well, take a look at this deck here. Yeah, that was fun. I had some really good games. So far, I didn't play against any decks that the Disenchant was good against. I played against, what, the Mirror, Standstill, the Mirror, and... what was the... oh, Dredge. But the sideboard seemed... again, I didn't play against either Workshops or Eldrazi, which is what a lot of the sideboard is devoted to, or Oath, but I did have my 5 Dredge cards. 5's cheating against Dredge, by the way. If you really want to beat Dredge, you need, like, 7. And 6 or 7... well... 7 doesn't just beat Dredge, but I think it gives you a favorable matchup. 6 gives you, like, a close matchup, and at 5, you're a dog. But I don't play against Dredge all that often, so I haven't wanted to overload. It's possible that the Aegis slot could just be another Rest in Peace, because it's one of the really good answers. And I like splitting up between enchantments and creatures, because there are very few cards that deal with both. Like, Nature's Claim and Firestorm don't overlap there, and, of course, dodging Ingoture. Also have a couple cards against Storm, just the one Arcane Lab, because that card's really good against them, and then Stony Silence, which is good against Storm and Workshops, but Cabal Therapy, I think, is going to be good against Storm as well. I really don't like counterspells against Storm, because they have so many defense grids. But yeah, that'll do it. This was a fun tournament to play in. I'm not sure about the Baleful Strixes yet, but again, those are partially for Eldrazi. You play against a Thought Not Seer, a Reality Smasher, and Baleful Strix will do some work, as well as the fact that it doesn't cost more under Thorn of Amethyst or Thalia. The therapies were good. Basically, when therapy is good, it's insane. You're like probe therapying them with Mentor out or Baleful Strix, and you're just like getting all their cards. When it's bad, it's really bad though, because it's not a blue card to pitch to Force, which something like Spell Pierce or Flusterstorm would be. And once everything's on the board and they've played out their hand, it doesn't do much either. And there are some matchups where that is the case. Still like Swords to Plowshares and by extension Path. But that'll do it for this time. Thanks for watching, and remember to visit channelfireball.com for sweet videos like this and any cards you may need.